Hey everybody, welcome back to Let's Play Legend of Zelda Minish Cap. I'm about to Junior X7, and last time, I'm drowning! Actually, not really. Last time, we went to go on a quest to find the quarry, and we were assisted by our hat, Ezlo! Wrong button. And he's basically just gonna tell us, what we need to do right now. He's basically like Navi, only less annoying. So anyways, let's go find somebody that might know. This place looks important. I've never seen an outfit like that before. Are you a human? Oh my god, this guy speaks English! Oh my, it's been quite some time since any humans came here. My name is The Story. I watch the Abbey as well as the Shrine to the North. You seem to be having some trouble with our language, don't you? You could use a jabbernut. It will allow you to understand our tongue. You should be able to find one in the barrel house just south of here. So, we're going south. Sorry if I sound a little tired, I just recorded the last episode and I haven't talked much recently. Anyways... Block pushing puzzles! Oh, Link, this must be the jabbernut Festaru told you about. Well, you better eat it if you plan on making any progress at all. Okay. I ate the jabbernut. Now you can understand the language of the Minish. Yep. Now we can... Yep, that's right, we can speak Pokemon now! So you've eaten the jabbernut and now you can understand us. The Elder said that humans can no longer see us as they once could. It's amazing that you can see us. Exactly. Because now, I can speak Pokemon. And I can go on my journey to become a Pokemon Master. Because I want to be the very best. And I promise not to sing. I don't want to kill my audience. Dear people! What? Start from the top over these, I'm too lazy. Not good for you. Hyrule Town's a bit shocking. I didn't even know that I can speak English. What should I do? So you've eaten the jabbernut and now you can understand us? Sorry, but I know a little about swords. I'm sure the Elder can help you. Okay. I'm just gonna go talk to the senile old man. I don't know that he's senile. Well, I'm just gonna guess. Anyways, this house looks important. You look old. You're the Elder. Oh! You speak our language! It's been quite a while since we've heard outsiders speak our tongue. We have little to offer you in these woods, but please, enjoy your stay. Thank you for your offer, but we have no time to relax. My name is Ezlo. This child is Link. We need to break a curse that has been cast on the Princess of Hyrule. To do so, we'll need to reforge the broken Picori blade. Ah, yes. And you come here now hoping to have the blade reforged? Well, if that's what you're after, you'll need four mystic elements. These elements are the crystalline forms of the energies of this world. Only by infusing the blade with these energies can a new blade be formed. Here, give me your map. I can mark where these elements can be found. Hey, there's one right next to the Minish Village! That's convenient. The Earth element can be found in the shrine to the north of Festari's Abbey. Speak with Festari. He will show you the path to the shrine's entrance. Go with caution. Evil creatures have lately made their homes in our shrine. Return to me at once after you have found the Earth element. Okay. So basically, we're going to be finding the element of ground types. This should be fun. You wish to go to the shrine? Very well, this way. Wild beasts have settled in recently. Be careful, it's quite dangerous. I am a child. I don't need to be afraid of danger. Anyways, yeah, this is actually where we found the heart piece earlier. Anyways, let's go inside. To our first dungeon! Deepwood Shrine. So this would be the Deepwood Shrine the Minish Elder spoke of. He said something about there being monsters inside, didn't he? Hey now, no reason to be afraid or anything. I'll be waiting right here. No wait, what am I saying? I'm not letting you leave me alone out here. Yeah, this dungeon has two heart pieces to be found. Anyway, simple puzzle is simple. And here's our enemies. floods. I believe we just need to kill them all. Or there's stuff I need to steal. Oh yeah, right. Simple puzzle here. Just light all four torches. You get a chest, which contains a small key. You open the door. Bingo, Buddha, Bada. You can use it only once in this dungeon. There's a locked door here. See if you can find a key to open it. I already have the key, Aslo. Anyways, this place is— oh my god, flying slugs! Anyways, moving on. Aslo, stop teaching me stuff! I am not an idiot! See, Aslo, I'm not an idiot. Anyways, we just do the same thing with the mushroom. Yeah! And then we just go and kill flying slugs. Anyways, here's the mushroom. We can't kill him yet. Hold on, right? Wow, look at the size of that barrel! Alright, how silly of me. It's not big, we're just small. Yeah, you forgot about that, you stupid ass though. Anyways, let's stand on this and— we burnt the barrel! Yay! Now it's time to go inside. Well, we can't roll the barrel yet. How sad. Anyways, we now need to go over here. And, point me out, we need to light both of these at the— I did not mean to jump down! Bad, Link! Bad, do not jump down without permission! Wrong what? Did I just mess this up? I'll be back in a second. Okay, I'm back. Now what you're supposed to do is walk very carefully past this. Push this on the button, then do that. That'll release the barrel. Anyways, now, after we get these guys out of the way, it's time to go barrel— shut up, Aslo! Yay, I'm barrel riding! Anyways, I kinda wanted to see what's through here first. Well, I can't push that out of the way. However, I can attack this bug and kill it. What would happen if I just went full force? That's a bad idea, going full force. However, we get the map if we go full force. So yeah, let's say. So yeah, now we just basically roll, and now, as if the floor gave you an indication, you have to do this. More to go through here. Kill the flying slugs, pick up a rupee, kill this bug, stand on this to complete the, something to hold down this switch. I know what. Let's push this pot onto the button. That should work. See? Puzzle solving! Once you take hold of something with R, use the blah to push it. I know. I know, Aslo. I played this game before. You are not Navi. Now we got a chest in there. I know what to do. Sneaky people think they can trick me, but I have a key. Sneaky people. Anyways, now that I'm drowning, now that I drowned, let's go through here. Out this way. Push this, and now let's make our way back. Now it's time to go barrel riding! Whee! shown there's a locked door there, but I'm going through here first. Ah, dang it, the one-way only door. Wait, just a button. Anyway, I want to see what's up here. Basically, it's just a shortcut back to another room. I'll go there later. Anyways, what I want to do is, I want to pull back, let her rip. So I can push this button, and now I can let back fully. I can let her rip fully and do this. Venture this way. And kill this slug. Kill you. Get money. Yeah, it's very strange. Oh my god, it's attacking the demon slugs! Okay, not that the slugs are dead. Just need to do this. Hooray, and what? I don't know what to do, I believe, is that we need to grab this and pull it onto here. Actually, no, that's not what we need to do. Pull it out like this. And now we need to push this onto the button. Simple as that. So yeah. And now, now it's a boss! Well, the music sounds cool. Basically, what we just need to do is kill these things. All you need to do is make sure they don't see you, and then just swing your sword at them like a madman. Very easy. We get a key this way. I know. It asked him to grab this money. Go on through. And now here we are, we're back where we started this area. However, now we can jump down here. Go through this way. And start attacking these things. Anyways, let's go downstairs. Look, there's a chest! How do I get that? What do I do here again? I can't progress in this room yet. Now there's a puzzler. I suspect there's not much more we can do here right now. Let's press on. Perhaps we can work this from another angle later on. Yeah, that's what we're supposed to do. But so first, I just feel like doing this. Why? Because it feels cool. And doing it that way is a dud. Now we can only go downstairs. Or to the left. Anyways. Ow! Wait, yeah, that opens that door, which just leads back to that main room from before. Oh, what's in here? A web! Anyways, if you saw, there was a mini boss. Now let's just go in here and fight the mini boss! We want to do is to attack his nose. At least I think it is. I mean, the nose is the obvious weak thing here. Okay, no, you don't attack his nose and just slash the heck out of his tail. Wait for him to calm down. Rush over here and now slash the heck out of his tail! Yeah, very simple. Slash his nose. Now slash the heck out of his tail! Yeah, I don't think he's very happy right now. Be happy, dude. Heck yeah, slash, 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 and he's dead! And we get a gigantic chest. Let's open it. And we get a gust jar, aka a leaf blower. Hold the button to draw things in and release to fire them out. Set it to ARB on the item screen to use it. Anyways, guys, I'll show you how to use it. First off, let me get the items, and then they'll let me set this. Basically, to use it, you can do this. Hold the button, and then you basically then just don't hold it long enough. We'll be able to release the gust jar of wind. Anyways, guys, now that we have the leaf blower, that's it for this episode. Next time on Legend of Zelda Minish Cap, we continue through the Deepwood Shrine. See you guys then.